Let's talk about finding the slope of a line using two points. So it turns out there are a couple of ways of finding the slope of a line, and in this case we'll just be using two points. So let's go ahead and graph a line to see how this works. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Let's go ahead and label these. -1, -2, -3, -4, -5. Okay, so let's say you had two points. Let's say you first had the point 1, 1. And you had a second point, let's say 5, 3. So 5, 3 is way over here. And let's say you graph the line through these two points. So when you graph that line, here's what you'd get. You'd get that line, okay? So we know already how to find the slope of this line. So recall that the slope, from what we talked about before, is, well, you take how much y changes by, and you divide it by how much x changes by. So when I look at this, I say to myself, okay, well, first of all, how much does x change by? Well, x starts at 1 and it goes all the way to 5, right? So if you're staying on this line, going from this point to that point, x starts at 1 and goes all the way to 5. So how much did x change by? Well, x changed by 4. So x went from 1 to 5, so x changed by 4. Now how much does y change by? Well, y, you're starting at, you know, y is 1, and you're ending up when at this point has a y of 3. So when you go up, the change in y I can see is from 1 to 3, and that would be 2. Now, when I did that, when I found my change in x and my change in y, you may have noticed that, well, if this point right here has coordinates, you know, 1, 1, and this point has coordinates 5, 3, you may have noticed that, well, x started at 1 and it ended at 5, and isn't that 5 take away 1? So don't I take the final x and from it subtract the initial x? And the same thing is true with y, right? Y ended up at 3, but it started at 1. And that's exactly how I got 2. 2, after all, is simply 3 take away 1. And so if you're thinking like that, what you're noticing is that these numbers, that is the 2 and the 4, how much the y changes by and how much the x changes by, can be found just by making use of these numbers, 3, 1, 5, and 1, which of course are just the coordinates of the points. So we have another way of writing the change in y over the change in x, and it's this. We write this, and I'll explain what this means in a moment. Y sub 2 minus y sub 1 over x sub 2 minus x sub 1. Now this gets used very often, so you want to make sure you understand what it means. And here's the meaning of it. You can see over here that you have two points, right? Let's call this our first point, and let's call this our second point. So that little y, do you see the 2 right there? What that means is the y coordinate of the second point. So if this is the second point, what's the y coordinate? That would be 3. So the y coordinate of the second point is 3. Take away, that is minus what? The y coordinate of the first point. Okay, this was the first point, right? And what's the y coordinate? That would be that 1 right there. So y coordinate first point is 1. And then you go on to the denominator. X coordinate second point. Okay, so I walk over here. X coordinate second point. Well, this is the second point, and that's the x coordinate. So this would be x sub 2, that 5. Take away, well, x coordinate first point, So here's the first point. There's the x coordinate. So it's 5 take away 1. And I get, well, 3 take away 1 is 2 over 5 take away 1, which is 4. And that's my slope. So I can see that all I needed was the coordinates to find the slope of the line. I actually didn't even need the graph. All I needed to know was 1.11 and a second point, 5.3. So why don't we go ahead and find the slope of another line where you don't have the graph. We're just going to make use of the formula that I just boxed, okay? Which you want to remember. This is a very important formula that gets used a lot. So let's go ahead and do that. Find the slope of a line using that formula. So, okay, find the slope of the line, okay, through the points, okay, here we go, -1, 3, and let's let the second point be -3, 5. Okay, so here we go. We remember the formula. M is y(2) minus y(1) divided by x(2) minus x(1). Now, the only thing you have to do is you have to decide what's the first point and which is the first point and which is the second point. Now, it turns out that decision doesn't matter. You'll get the same answer no matter what, which is kind of interesting. So how about I just decide this to be point 1 and this to be point 2. Now with that decision, I follow my formula. What is the y-coordinate of the second point? Well, second point, y-coordinate is 5. Take away, right, y-coordinate of the first point. First point, y-coordinate is 3. Okay, now let's go on to the denominator. X-coordinate of the second point. Well, here's the second point. There's the x-coordinate. So it would be -3, take away, right? X-coordinate of the first point. Here's the first point. There's the x-coordinate. So the x-coordinate was -1. Notice how I had to take away a negative, so I needed parentheses. And what do I get? Well, 5 take away 3 is 2, divided by, well, -3, remember, when you subtract a negative, that changes to addition. So it's -3 plus 1, which is -2. And this is my slope. And so let's see, 2 divided by -2 is equal to -1. So that would be the answer to this question. Now, you might be asking, is there another way to find the slope of a line? And it turns out there is. And we're going to develop something called the slope-intercept form of a line. And we'll see that amongst other things, gives us the slope of a line. So there are multiple ways of finding the slope of the line, and in this video that we did just now, we found it using two points.